Good morning. Happy Mother's Day. Welcome to the Grants Pass Center for Spiritual Living. It's so lovely to see so many little faces. Welcome, welcome. I had a wonderful time putting together our set for Mother's Day, our music set. You're going to recognize a lot of the songs that we're going to sing. They're not kind of the thing we usually do here, but I think you'll have a lot of fun with it. So let's go ahead and get started. Oh, I'm Trasia, by the way, for those of you who don't know me. One of the many wonderful gifted musicians who bless our center here with music every Sunday. Let's see what we got here. Okay, you recognize this piece? That's all I have for music. Can you turn it up a little bit? There, okay. Okay, we'll get this worked out. That's how it goes. Ready?
Oh, here we go. May the good Lord be with you down every road you walk. And may sunshine and happiness surround you when you're far from home. And may you grow to be proud, dignified and true. And do unto others as you have done to you,
to our kids and our grandkids.
Be courageous and be brave, and in my heart you'll always stay. Forever young, forever young, forever young.
Great!
May the fortress be with you, may your guiding light be strong. Build your head so you're heard with the prince of that everlong.
She's the prince.
And may you never live in vain. And in my heart you will remain forever young.
Great
job.
Going on.
When you find your fire, will be hoping that a search will help. For all the wisdom of a mother, no one could ever tell.
Hear this now.
But whatever road you choose, I'm right behind you with all the roots.
So much and telling them. And so all week I've been practicing this next song and I keep crying. So I'm not going to cry this time because there's so many people I want to tell. Moms, grandmoms, dads, mothers,
haven't told you lately that I love you. Have I told you there's no one else above you? Fill my heart with gladness. Take away all the sadness. Ease my troubles as much as you please. A morning sun in the morn and its glory greets each day with hope and comfort too. Fill my life with mountains. You know what makes me better. Touch my spirit, that's what you do. There's a love that's divine, and it's yours and it's mine. Like the sun and moon. At the end of the day, we just give thanks and praise to the Lord. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one else? Fill my heart with gladness. Take away all my sadness. Please, my troubles, that's what you do. Surrender your heart somewhere out of your way. Just let yourself set it up. Mom, you should. Alright, here we go. There's a love that's divine. And it's yours and it's mine. Like the sun. At the end of the day, we give thanks and pray to the Lord. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one else above you? Fill my heart with gladness. Take away all my sadness. Ease my troubles, that's what you do. Take away all my sadness. And fill up my life with gladness. Ease my troubles, that's what you do. Thanks, moms. Thanks, grandmas. Thank you, nurturers. Thank you, love.
Thank you, Tricia. Mm-hmm. Cheer for Tricia. Well, good morning. Welcome to the Grants Pass Center for Spiritual Living. I'm Reverend Steve Van Meter, your senior minister. And happy Mother's Day. It's Mother's Day. Do we have any moms in the house? Any moms in the house? We got some moms in the house. Well, I have a little gift for y'all. If you'd like to put your hands up. We have. Yeah, all of a sudden the guys' hands go up. Everybody, you know what? If you ever even acted like a mom, you can get a rose today. So please, everybody gets a rose that wants one. But I want to thank you for your service as a mom, as a grandma, as a person in someone else's life that has been there through the loving times and been there through the challenging times. I mean, that's part of the, you know, when you sign on for being a mom, you don't just sign on for the good times, right? You're there for the extended run, as it were. Well, we're going to, as she passes those out, we're going to do what we do every Sunday, and we're going to recite our vision mission statement up on the screen, which says,
We are an open-minded spiritual community dedicated to evolving consciousness through teaching spiritual principles.
So I want to thank you all for being here today, and I have some announcements. Friday night, did we have a good time Friday night? We had a great time. We're in the midst of our fundraising campaign. We did dinner and a movie, and we watched, what was it, Forever Young? Or
yeah.
Timely, right? Young at Heart. It's a really good movie, and we had a wonderful Cinco de Mayo styled food fair, and it was wonderful. We had a great time, and I want to thank everybody who helped with that. It was Chris and myself and Priscilla, Guy and Jan, and all who attended. There was a lot of food that was made by a lot of different people, but let's just give them a little hand. Just having dinner and a movie, we raised $433. Here, we're mighty in coins. And that entire amount will be donated to our air conditioning and new kitchen fund, which brings me into my announcements. And I want to bring Paula up, who is our board president practitioner, to give you an update on the amounts that we've raised. We just started this last Sunday, and our goal is 8,700. That includes 6,700 for the new air conditioning and 2,000 for the cost of fixing the kitchen. So, Paula, let us know.
So before I reveal the final amount, it's just pretty fun. Okay, so we had some very special contributors. I want to thank our practitioner group as a whole. We donated $1,000 to this fund. Wow. So, all of you practitioners. And also we had a special donation of $1,000 from Chip and Bucky. They're not here, but they sent an extractor. And then last week we made $310 just from our congregation, and then the $433 at dinner and a movie. So the final total, the final reveal for 1 week of our fundraiser. Third of the way there, so yay! So keep on donating, and it's the blue to keep cool, right? I know it doesn't feel like we need an air conditioner today, but it will come, the sun will come out, and we will need that. So it's the blue envelopes on the back. So thank you all. And if you don't have a blue envelope, just put it in the memo line of the check for the air conditioning fund. Thank you.
Well, and I just want to remind everybody that our contributions to this fund is up and above and beyond what you normally give, so that we can still have the weekly running of the center, because we still have our water bill and electric bill and all the other bills. So as you're writing that check, please keep in mind that we still have our weekly contributions that we count on. So that is our update on those donations. We have a fundraising concert coming up Sunday, May 22nd. Anton and Laura will be doing the music for our service that day. And afterwards, they will be doing a concert on May 22nd. That's not this next Sunday, Sunday after that. So please mark your calendars and please be here. It'll start promptly at noon, and they do about an hour for us. But those proceeds will also go to our fund. Kitchen Angels Needed. If you like food or just like the camaraderie of being in the kitchen with other like-minded people or in service in any way, please see Paula after the service, and she can let you know. We need dishwashers and cleanup crews especially needed. Since our dishwasher sprang a leak, We've been doing all the dishes by hand. So I don't know, did you take all those dishes home Friday night? And
Ralph and Gian.
Well, somehow the dishes got done. They are clean. Everything's fine. But it would be nice to get that dishwasher hooked back up. So that's part of what we're collecting funds for. Foundations class. I will be teaching foundations. It begins this Thursday, May 12th, from 6 to 9 p.m. It's a 10-week class, and it is free. Wow, it's usually $200. But we're offering it free if you would like to know more about our teaching, more about our center, and you just want to meet people in your congregation. This is the best way to do it. And it will cost $45 for the registration fee. That gets you your certificate. That's how we register you with the home office so that you can get that certificate. And you also need to buy your own textbook. They're about $15, and you can buy them back at the bookstore. But we have waived the price, the $200. The board and I thought that it was important for people who want to know more about this teaching to not have to pay to figure it out. They can come and have this class for free. It's 10 weeks, and it is a wonderful introduction to the science of mind. Our fundraising committee, we are having a community fund fair Saturday, June 25th from 10 to 4 p.m. This is gonna be incredible. I hope that you guys can make it. We're going to have food, music, arts, crafts, fun demonstrations, and metaphysically inspired services will be included. Would you like to be a vendor? Because we are honoring applications from our congregation first and foremost, because we want you guys to have the first opportunity to share what you do in the community. So we're hoping that you can come and be a vendor with us. And you'll need to contact Wendy. Wendy, raise your hand. There she is. And there are, if you have questions about the application, there are some applications, I believe, back on the counter. And you can contact me or Chris. Chris, raise your hand. Chris, my partner, is helping with this. And Paula. And this is just a great thing that we're doing for the community. It's all going to be in this room and on our grounds outside and in the parking lot. We're going to have food trucks and all sorts of fun. So, yeah, it's going to be a big event, all hands on deck. We need your help, or we need you to attend and bring a friend. Okay. Metaphysical book study groups, Sunday mornings from 9 to 9:45 in our conference room. And it started this morning, the new book that we started, This Thing Called You by Dr. Ernest Holmes. This incredible book leads you deeper into the words and philosophy of Dr. Ernest Holmes. The books will be available in the bookstore. I don't think they've quite come in yet, but they will come in this week. So by next Sunday, we'll have more books. But a love offering is taken, and we'd love to connect with you. And I think that today that our pop group, the People on Purpose group, is doing something at the Pacifica Mother's Day spring event. This group will be staffing a youth activity table and art project and learning about Oregon bees in the rain. Well, everybody needs water. We are so blessed. Every drop that we get, we will take, because we want to have a wonderful, clear summer, don't we?
Yeah.
Well, again, thank you all for being here this morning, and we will stand as we sing We Are One.
Yeah, you can hold each other's hands if you like. Here we go.
We are one. We are one.
Yes,
I am you. You are me. We are one. And in this unity, we shall live in harmony as peace has come, as we are one. We are one. We are one. I am you, you are me, we are one. And in this unity, we shall live in harmony, as peace has come, as we are one.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's read the gratitude together.
How grateful I am to bravely face fear when it arises so that I can stretch and grow.
And so it is. Let's see. So welcome again to the Grants Pass Center for Spiritual Living. I'm Deborah Perdue. I'm a licensed practitioner here. I just love this community so much, and it's such a pleasure and honor to be a practitioner here. Paula is our podium practitioner today, and she's here to hold the high watch, meaning she's here to really feel the peace and the love and the joy in this room and circulate it all around, and to the Zoom people too. And we, the practitioners, love to pray with and for you. And so you can see Paula to be directed to a practitioner to pray, have a short prayer, affirmative prayer after the service, short and mighty, I might say. And if you're a practitioner and you're willing to pray, will you raise your hand? Tracia, me, and Paula. Thank you. And also we have the yellow prayer forms that are on the seat in front of you. The back of the seat in front of you, and you can fill that out and you can put it in the offertory, or there's also a box on the practitioner table. And the blue ones, which everyone's really been sending demonstrations, the blue ones are for manifestations. After we prayed with and for you, then we'd love to hear how it came out the way we wanted it to come out. So use the blue forms to let us know that too. And also, on our CSL website, which is grantspasscsl.org, there's a prayer form there, and you can fill that out as well. Thank you. The flowers are from Paula. Is anyone here for the very first time? If so, please raise your hand. Welcome. And you're going to get a gift and some information about us from Reverend Steve. Remember to silence your cell phones if you haven't already. And let's read the prayer together that's on the screen.
I live my life in faith, feeling fear, then letting it dissolve. I firmly trust that all is well. And I know without a doubt that I am always supported by God. And so it is.
And please remain seated as we sing I Am Loved.
Oh, yeah, I am. I am I am loved. The love of God is in my life. I am loved.
And now I have a short reading, and then we're going to go into medication. Meditation for a minute or two. And actually, meditation is medication. Yes. So I found just recently this reading on mothers from Thich Nhat Hanh in his daily guide, which I love. Our mother is the person who first teaches us love, the most important subject in life. Without my mother, I would have never known how to love. Thanks to her, I can love my neighbors. Thanks to her, I can love all living beings. Through her, I acquired my first notions of understanding and compassion. Mother is the foundation of all love, and many religious traditions recognize this and pay deep honor to a maternal figure such as the Virgin Mary or the goddess Kuan Yin. An infant barely has to open her mouth to cry before her mother is already running to the cradle. Mother is a gentle and sweet spirit who makes unhappiness and worries disappear. When the word mother is uttered, already we feel our heart overflowing with love. And I also have a short prayer from Reverend Scott Aubrey, who he's in our movement, and he sends out daily things that are just amazing. And this was his prayer today having to do with mothers. Thank you, Infinite Presence, for the God quality in mothers that nurtures life and holds everything together in pure love. Thank you for the feminine essence that shows us what unconditional givingness looks like. Thank you for the beauty, gentleness, and eloquence of divine love that reveals itself in the form of our mothers. Amen. So let's take a minute or two and really saturate our souls in that feeling for the love of nurturing mothers of all kinds. And so slowly open your eyes and get grounded in your chair and come back to this room. And now it's time for some special music from beautiful Tracia, followed by Reverend Stephen's talk. Thank you.
Go ahead and turn them all the way up. Yeah, there you go. Thank you. All right, so this is, I waited a while to sing this song. I love this song from Mother's Day. One of my favorites. Oh, I probably better have volume on. Hold on. Turned it off trying to eliminate the buzz. All right. Let's see. That should be better. All right. Oh, that's okay. Hold on. There we go.
These are the gifts of the goddess, love, joy, and peace. Gifts of the goddess, are you ready to receive? All the gifts of the goddess, love, joy, and peace. Gifts of the goddess, are you ready to receive? Love, are you ready? Joy. Are you ready? Peace. Are you ready? Are you ready to receive? These are the gifts of the goddess, love, joy, and peace. Gifts of the goddess, I am ready to receive. All the gifts of the goddess, love, joy, and peace. Gifts of the goddess, I am ready to receive. Love, I am ready.
Are you ready?
Joy, I am ready. Peace, I am ready. I am ready.
to receive.
Sing on now.
These are the gifts of the goddess. Love, joy, and peace. Talk about gifts of the goddess. I am ready to receive all the gifts of the goddess. Love, joy, and peace. Gifts of the goddess. I am ready to receive. Compassion. Are you ready? Forgiveness. I am ready. Laughter. I am ready to receive. Passion. Oh, I am ready. Success.
Are you ready?
Oh, yes, I'm ready. Abundance.
Bring it on.
Oh, yes, I'm ready. Ready to receive.
Are you ready?
These are the gifts of the goddess. Love, joy, and peace. Come on. Gifts of the goddess. I am ready to receive all the gifts of the goddess. Love, joy, and peace. Gifts of the goddess. I am ready to receive. I am ready.
Say it with me. Here we go.
I am ready.
Bring it on.
I am ready, ready to receive. Oh, I am ready to receive. Yes, I am ready to receive all the gifts. All the gifts. Yes.
Well, thank you, Tricia. Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy Mother's Day again, right? Well, here we are in the midst of spring and May, and it's raining. It's actually snowing out this morning. But then, as you looked on the hills, that little sugar covered, maybe you live in it. Well, the theme for May is living everyday wonder. Emotions, and today's title is called The Fear Factor. Oh, the fear factor. So for too long, many of us have allowed fear to plague our lives and deter us from our good. You know, it's been the fear that has kept us away from doing the things that we really want to do. You know, fear of not achieving a goal, or actually the fear of achieving it. And it may not even be something that you thought about, but sometimes it's the fear of actually doing what you would love to do that keeps you from doing it. We have the power to change our narrative and allow faith to lead us instead of fear. But when the fear comes up, what do? Do we run? What's your way? Do you hide? Do you get busy doing something else? Do you pretend it's not there? Do you whistle past the graveyard? Our emotions are amazing resources that help us learn about ourselves. And in this science of mind teaching, we know that our feelings are the direct connection to spiritual energy. That those are the means by which we experience and express life. Our feelings and our emotions serve as a guide to us in our processing center for areas of reflection, exploration, and growth. And there are so many emotions to choose from on the emotional continuum. Last week, we talked about our emotional spice rack. You know, that we have all these different spices that we can choose from, you know, fear and jealousy. How about truth and forgiveness and love and exaltation and whoa? But, you know, for some reason, we choose, when fear comes up, we tend to run or hide or, like I said, pretend it's not there. Fear is one of the most common human emotions, and instead of allowing fear to paralyze or deter us, we can focus on the other end of the spectrum and move through our fears with faith. We can stretch and grow and expand and give proper tools for support. In our foundations class, part of one of the experiences is a project called The Fear to Faith, How to Transfer Your Fears into Your Faith. And there's an actual, we spend about 4 hours on just figuring out how to do that in our lives. Because when we can move, you know, fear is going to come up. It's part of our experience. You know, it keeps us from stepping in front of buses, you know, or from getting too close to an edge, especially if you are, you know, one of those people that can't even step on a step stool, or, you know, because it's too high. You're like, whoa. If you have that fear, that can push you in a different direction when you use that energy in its correct way. It's like anger. Anger, when used with physical violence, is a problem. But anger that moves you to do something in your life to fix something is the proper use of anger. If it moves you into a new realm, I know I got very angry at situations in my life, and it wasn't until I got so angry that I had to do something about it that changed my life forever. You know, the more that I ran, the more things stayed the same. But the more I addressed the fear and looked it straight in the eye, all of a sudden it lost its zing. It lost its energy. I was in no way afraid anymore. And from that fear, my faith grew. And I know that it was onto something there. And we can all do this. First, we must identify and acknowledge and face the fear. Most of us are raised and trained to embody fear in numerous ways. And there's also the human trigger mechanism to fear that includes fight or flight or a freeze response as a physical protective system. You know, when you see a bear, you know, all of a sudden these endorphins are opened. And all this adrenal gets pumped into you and you start breathing differently, your eyes get big, and you start looking for an exit strategy. How can I get out of here? Some of you had that same feeling when you walked into this center for the first time. Maybe you sat towards the door in case they said something, a little woo-woo, and you were like, oh, it's not for me, I'm out of here quick, I'm done here. But some of you have actually stayed and are moving closer to the front, I've noticed. Especially if you're challenged with our wonderful audio system that we have here that loves to have a hum of its own. I'm just saying. So there's fear in failure. There's fear in success. There's fear of death. There's... How about flying? Is everybody cool with flying? I don't like getting in a plane all the time, but I've resigned myself that if I want to get somewhere else, I've got to suspend that belief and pretend that I'm just in a moving bus or something where I can get, when it stops, I can get out. But there are other responses to the fear, which is doubt and worry and anxiety and unworthiness, dread, insecurity. Oh, you know, it goes on. All the things, the challenging things that fear brings up. So what's the other side of that? From a spiritual perspective, the way to overcome fear is through it. You can't go around it. What happens when you go around it? It grows as you drive by. Because we haven't addressed it. But when we address it and we look at it and put it in its place, all of a sudden, it's just another thing. It's just another identification in our lives. Faith is the mental equivalent of fear at the opposite side of the spectrum. With the development of faith comes trust and knowing how to focus on the trust when fear comes up and know that our faith is bigger than the fear. All of a sudden, we have a different response mechanism. And what happens is the synapses in the brain start to detach and reattach on faith rather than fear. And when that begins to happen, when something comes up like a bear in front of you, instead of running, you might take a breath and slowly back away. Because as we know, when something runs, something else wants to chase it. You ever played with your cat? That's why your cat loves to chase after those little toys, is that it's wanting to get it. So faith helps us to push through our fear. And as Susan Jeffers coined the phrase, feel the fear and do it anyway, which means that we identify, yes, we're in fear, but it is not going to be in my way any longer. And hopefully our moms help teach us this, right? Do you ever have a bully in school? I had a guy that always hit me up and took my lunch money. And, I couldn't even tell anybody about it. You know, it's like one of those things that you just get used to it happening. And when my parents found out through me being hungry at home, they're like, did you eat lunch? I'm like, well, I gave up my lunch money to the bully. And all of a sudden, it was this whole thing. And then I could address the fear. And when we address it and we talk about it, it starts to take the air out of the balloon. It starts to go down little by little. And faith helps us to push through that fear. Faith empowers action and includes letting go by the use of knowledge. When we know how something works, it's no longer a fear to us. If you know how the law works, when you know that the law, that energy flows where your attention goes, and your attention is on fear, you're actually building that up. You're actually blowing more air into the fear balloon by your attention to it. Well, how do you not attend to fear? By remembering that you are spirit. You can never not be part of the spiritual energy. This is just how it works. You are an intricate part of this puzzle. And within your very DNA are spiritual muscles that when you begin to turn away from what doesn't work, not to deny it, but not to give it any more power, you start to blow up the balloon of faith, taking air out of the fear balloon. Which leads me to my three talking points. Fear causes more fear. Fear tends to draw out the worst in people, and somehow every insecurity that we didn't know we had shows up when fear is present. Do you ever have that situation where you're like having a bad day, and then something comes along that reaffirms that, and you're like, I knew I shouldn't have gotten out of bed today, and then something else happens, and it just is this like, I just want to go home. I just want to go home and get back into bed and turn off and put my head under the covers and pretend it's not happening. Well, that works for so long, as long as you're under the covers. But at some point, you got to come out. You got to wake up and you've got to face what the fear is. And information takes the zing out of our pain. We can talk that we are not true or real because we are fearful and doubtful. If energy flows where attention goes, a metaphysical acronym for fear is false evidence appearing real, which is based on the premise that if we fear and we know what the fear is, it's like the boogeyman under the bed. You know, when my dad would come in and put the lights on and say, look under your bed, there's nothing there but your shoes. I was like, yeah, but my mind thought that there was something else. And that's where we get into trouble, is that we have this thing called a thinker and we can't turn it off. Like I said last week, I want you to stop thinking right now. Just stop that. You're thinking about not thinking right now, aren't you? Well, that's because you can't stop your thinker, but we can direct it. That's what this whole science of mind is all about. It's about changing your thinking, and it changes your life. If you can redirect your thinking to what you do want to be, do, and have, you start attracting that automatically. This is how the law works. Just like the law of buoyancy. If you were to take a hunk of lead and throw it into the water, it would sink. But you take that same hunk of lead and you pound it thin and shape it like a cup or a boat. And all of a sudden, that same weight distributed equally will create this thing called the law of buoyancy. Aren't you glad we figured that out? You know, but it's that it can weigh the same amount, but it's how it's shaped that makes the difference. That takes the fear of swimming out of boat travel. Well, for most of us, some you guys still have your life jacket on. Be safe. But it's the same thing with the if you tried to fly. I mean, you know, you can flap your arms as hard as you'd like. We know that it doesn't work. I tried jumping off the roof several times and proved that it does not work that way. But get yourself an aeroplane and know how the law of aerodynamics work, and you're working and flying across the universe all of a sudden. It's how we think that makes the difference. We can then become part of the solution rather than part of the problem. We then aren't in fight or flight mode all the time. Now, if somebody scares you, or let's say a car pulls out in front of you, you're going to have that feeling of, which makes you hit the brake. That's part of safety. Like I said, that keeps us from stepping in front of buses. But when it keeps you from, like, stepping in front of people to talk, how many people have the fear of speaking in front of a group of people? Yeah, you know, I've got that same fear too. Well, I had it really bad before I became a minister. But something happened in ministerial school, but that's on you. If you're going for that, come see me. We'll have a talk and we'll get over that. But that fight or flight is still going to be there. But if you can talk yourself off the ledge when you feel like running, and go, you know what? I know that within me is a power that is bigger than anything that can happen to me. You can do anything. You know, we can talk ourselves onto the ledge. And we can talk ourselves off. And it's all in how we do our self-talk. If you know that every word you're saying to yourself is a prayer, how would you speak to yourself differently when you've made a silly mistake? Like, oh, you special person. You are so creative. Look at how you messed that up. You messed that up so good. And have fun with it. That will attract. Now, this isn't to take away the seriousness of something that may have happened to you. But a little levity can go a long way. Number two, jump off the cliff of faith. When we think of jumping off a cliff, we typically think of crashing due to gravity. However, when we think of jumping off the metaphorical cliff of faith, infinite possibilities abound. This is where healing begins to happen for us. You know, you get to a point in this teaching where it's not just something you're, a law that you're looking at. It becomes a law that you're living. And you start testing these new laws that you've found, and you find that they actually work. All of a sudden, you realize that if you are on a ledge, you're either going to fly, or when you hit the water, you're going to float. Or you won't hit anything at all, and you will transform into another creature and become the air that you're jumping into. But this is what happens. In the moment that we feel the fear and do it anyway, is where our faith begins to build. And all we need is one little success to begin to break open that new sense of faith. You know, there is a way for each one of us to get through our challenges. We just have to find that way. If we give up, when we give up, we lock in our challenges. That's the end of our story. But when we keep moving through it, it's not the end of our story, it's the beginning of our success. And if we can see it as the beginning of our success rather than the end of our story, everything changes. So faith doesn't go away. When new challenges arise, we may just have to call on that faith and remind ourselves of how faithful we are. Given the cumulative nature of faith building, it gets easier over time. You get better at what you're doing. You ever attempt to do something and fail miserably? And then you went, I'm never going to try that again. But you tried it again, and you had a little bit of success, and all of a sudden you had a little more success. All of a sudden you were doing it, and all of a sudden you realized you could do it. You were building your faith that you can do this. Maybe call somebody that believes in you, or maybe somebody that doesn't know you at all, a practitioner or a minister, and go, you know, I'm working with this situation. I'm hoping that we can talk about building my faith. And watch what happens. Watch what it does to your inner being when you start to have a success. Because one success builds on another and builds on another. And all of a sudden, the fear that you used to have is no longer there. It diminishes back into the nothingness from which it came. Which leads me to my third point, the fear factor. Fear usually involves taking a risk. You know, I didn't take a lot of risks because I was afraid of failing. But I didn't have any successes either because I didn't take any risks. The only way to have a success is to take a risk. Maybe you won't get that job. Maybe it won't work out. But maybe it will. There's just as many percentage points that it will work out as there won't. And maybe it's not always 50-50. Maybe it's 75-25. But all you need is one point to build on. You could have 99 trillion against you. But if you believe in yourself, in 1%, you are on your way. You know, a lot of people may not believe, but that's where they are in consciousness, not where you are in consciousness. Don't let that become your consciousness. Let them have their disbelief. God bless them in their disbelief, because that's for them. That's where they are. Don't let it become yours. Some people may take more risks, and when fear is present, maybe they shy away. Other people may be more daring, prone to take risks, you know, like if you're having a portfolio, you know, and they ask you, what's your risk quota? You know, are you willing to go all in, or are you more of a long-term, short, you know, little investor? It's up to you how you want to spend your money. But the more aggressive you are, the bigger the payoff or the loss. But if you don't play, you can't win. You know, if you want to win the lottery, start by buying a ticket. You can't win if you don't play. There's no right or wrong answer, because we each have to deal with our own comfort levels in life. We may, it may be beneficial for those who are skeptical and about taking risks due to the fear factor, and push past their comfort zones to stretch and grow. If we never stretch, we never grow. If we never take a little risk, we won't know what it means to take a big one. Start where you're at. Maybe you'll decide to take a Toastmasters class before you get up and talk in front of people. Maybe you just have a little group that you start talking in front of. You know, start with 3 or 4 people. You don't have to start with 50, you know. Start where you're comfortable. So sometimes it's better to slow down too. Don't go too fast. Don't rush into things. You know, sleep on it. You know, take some time to understand what you're working with, no matter which end of the spectrum you find yourself. Fear usually requires being vulnerable, taking an honest look at your situation, and telling the truth about ourselves. You know, if you can't be truthful to everybody around you, at least be truthful to yourself. Start there. We've got to start somewhere, right? So in conclusion, awareness is the key to conquering your fear. The more aware you are that those monsters under your bed aren't real, the easier it is to get out of bed in the morning, isn't it? Whether they're on the surface or buried deep within, if we allow ourselves to openly and honestly explore our fear, we can get the root cause and lay the groundwork for healing. Vulnerability is an important aspect of moving through our fears so that we can peel away the layers and see what's really going on underneath. And when we realize that fear begets more fear, then we can act more consciously from this awareness. And when we can examine our response to the fear factor to see how it drives our behavior and ways of showing up, we can call forth faith instead of fear. And all of a sudden, we are healed. And so it is.
And so it is.
Well, it's time for our prayer time. We're going to leave the lights up because of the hum that we get when we turn it down. So we just realize that's what the hum is from. So, well, if you'd like to just close your eyes if that's comfortable for you, or take a soft focus on the beautiful flowers or the candles up here, let's take a moment and remember who we are. So in following our teaching, we remember that there is a power. You can call it whatever you choose, the Christ consciousness, Jesus the Christ, source energy, great spirit. That's your business. But I think we can agree that there is a power. And that power is manifested in each one of us. For we are unified in this field of all the possibility. There is truly only one of us here. God, expressing as the countless life forms that exist everywhere. And each one of us is an intricate part of that power. And as we tune in and turn into that power is identified as who and what we are. It is right here and right now activated in each one of our lives, in a way that makes sense individually, See, I may not know what you're walking through, but I know that the power that created you does. And as we activate that power right here and right now, the sound of my voice, a new connection is made. A new energy is brought to our lives. And a new love is happening within each one of us all the time. It is the love of the faith, of the idea that we can do anything we choose to do. As long as we don't hurt ourselves or anyone else, there is power there. And it starts from our love. We love to express. That's why we're here. And as that love becomes our life, new connections are made. New ideas are bubbled up within us, and new expression becomes who and what we are. That in our bodies, all the right molecules are moved to where the perfect healing is happening. And in the body of our affairs, things are moving and happening because healing is happening and ongoing. So we give great thanks for this, knowing that that healing is already happening right here and right now for each one of us. We let go. We release this word directly into the living, loving law of mind, where it is already done, as we affirm it together by saying,
yes, so it is.
Amen. It's time for our offertory now. So if you'd like to take your gift and put it on your heart, let's recite our prosperity sharing affirmation together.
So thankful for the lavish, rich abundance of life I share with what I am giving you, heart, and so it is.
And now some music for Trisha.
So there's the size of the chant I'd like to share with you. Karen Drucker, actually, from a long time ago, so some of you may know this one.
Oh, Mother God, flowing through our hearts, we give thanks for the bread of our lives, for our hands in the earth, and the fruit of your womb, oh, Mother God. Blessed be, O Mother God, blessed be, O Mother God, flowing through our hearts, we give thanks for the bread of our lives, for our hands in the earth, and the fruit of your womb, O Mother God, blessed be. O Mother God, blessed be. O Mother God, thank you for this day, for the love that you wash over me, and this joy in my heart, I will share with the world, O Mother God, blessed be. One more time. O Mother God, thank you for this day, for the love that you wash over me, and this joy in my heart, I will share with the world, O Mother God, blessed be. O Mother God, blessed be.
Let's say a prayer for our offertory this morning. From the love of pure spiritual energy, these tithes and gifts have been collected. They are evidence of our faith, our belief, and our ability to manifest in this world of form. They do good work in the world and in the Grants Pass Center for Spiritual Living, and allow this community to be open and available to those who choose to remember who they are, and even those who may not know that yet. And for this, we are all well blessed. And so it is.
And so it is.
And it's now time for our closing song. So stand on up and let's do it again.
So thanks for taking a tour of music on Mother's Day with me. And one of the things that moms do is we stand. We stand and we are the peace and the joy of the world. So we'll sing that. So let there be peace. I am a stand for peace. Let there be love. I am a stand for love. Let there be joy. I am a stand for joy. We are making a new world now. Let there be peace. I am a stand for peace. Let there be love. I am a stand for love. Let there be joy. I am a stand for joy. We are making a new world now. We are making a new world now. We are making a new world and now.
Thank you for bringing that attention.
Welcome to benediction, so please repeat after me. Something wonderful is happening right now.
Something wonderful is happening right now.
It's happening in my mind.
It's happening in my heart.
It's happening in my body.
It's happening in my body.
It's happening in the body of my affairs.
It's happening in the body of my affairs.
I think it.
I think it.
I feel it.
I feel it.
And I know it.
I know it.
Just the way that it is.
Just the way it is.
And just the way it is not.
Just the way it is not.
Thank you, life.
Thank you, life.
Have an awesome week. Happy Mother's Day, everyone.